mobilizing the world for an outbreak of so-called disease X. That is one of the core missions of Dr. Richard Hatchett, who is the CEO of the Coalition for Epidemic Preparedness Innovations, or CEPI for short. Dr. Hatchett, thanks so much for being here at the BioBus Center.
Thanks, Mike. It's a real pleasure to be here.
For those who are not familiar with this acronym, what is CEPI? How long has it been around? What does it do?
Okay, CEPI is a public-private partnership that's been established since January of 2017.
Not that long ago.
No, it's brand new. We're about 16 months into its existence. We were established at Davos in 2017 to develop vaccines against epidemic disease threats. It was really a byproduct of the Ebola epidemic in 2014-2015 and a realization that the world needed to be better prepared for these threats.
Dr. Hatchett, speaking of Ebola, it recently reared its ugly head again in the Republic of Congo.
Yep.
Other key opinion leaders and experts are saying that the Zika virus is also kind of lying in wait and it's going to pop up at some point. It's not a question of if, but when. Yep. So how, when it's no longer in the headlines, not front page news, not on cable news day in and day out, do you maintain stakeholder engagement and keep focused on the mission you just talked about?
Well, I think the world has actually come to realize that epidemic threats are perpetual, and that even though you can't predict which threat will come next, whether it will be Ebola, whether it'll be Zika, Lassa fever, or some other threat, we know that there will be threats. And I think CEPI actually embodies the recognition on the part of the world that we need to actually prepare for these threats prospectively. The outbreak of Ebola in the Democratic Republic of Congo, in the DRC, is a terrific example of what happens when you are prepared. 4 years ago, when Ebola broke out in West Africa in 2014, the world was not prepared. It was slow to respond. There were vaccines and therapeutics that had been under development for more than a decade, and it took more than a year to move those into the field to test them during that epidemic, and they had very little, if any, impact on the control of that epidemic. Fast forward to today, 2018. Merck was able to deploy a vaccine into the DRC 13 days after the epidemic was identified. More than 1,000 people have now been vaccinated, and the epidemic, we think, is going to be brought under control. It's a really exciting advance.
No, that's great news. But can we get to a point, more broadly speaking, not just regarding Ebola, where we can either greatly diminish or maybe even eliminate the ongoing threat of a global epidemic?
I'm going to go out on a limb. I'm going to say that we can, if we can effectively mobilize the political will to do it, we can eliminate the threat of epidemics. That's not to say that we can eliminate the risk of outbreaks. Diseases will still emerge. Outbreaks will still occur. But we can prevent them from becoming national security threats, from becoming threats to global health security. I'll give you two examples. That sounds like an outlandish thing to say. Mm-hmm. But look at where we are today with HIV. There are still millions of people who are infected, but in the year 2000, the intelligence community here in the United States issued an estimate. They estimated that 100 million people would die of HIV in Africa within 5 years. They estimated that countries would fall apart, that life expectancies would fall by 20 or 30 years. That estimation of the security threat that HIV, you know, posed, coupled with the activism, obviously, of HIV sufferers, mobilized, galvanized political will. It led to the creation of things like PEPFAR and to other programs that have delivered life-saving medications to people in Africa who we never imagined could afford these medications. Look at where we are with famines. 40, 50 years ago, famines were part of, you know, they just happened. The rains didn't fall, food, you know, crops failed, and people starved. We've now put in place international institutions, response mechanisms, surveillance systems, and except in places like Yemen or North Korea, where either political causes or conflict prevent us from going and addressing shortfalls of food, famine has been eliminated as a threat to the human populations. We can get there with epidemics. We just have to have the political will to do so.
And that progress made in no small part due to the life sciences companies within the biotechnology industry. So an audacious but achievable mission, according to Dr. Richard Hatchett,
absolutely,
the CEO of CEPI. And thanks for joining us here at the BioBuzz Center.